After the previous defeats to Jarrow FC and Hartnam Westall, Seton went into the final fixture of February looking to pick up a vital 3 points against bottom of the table Wolverhampton FC. However, through injuries and other circumstances, manager Mark Lyons was unable to name a very depleted squad and even having to include himself in the starting lineup to make up the numbers. Seton made the best possible start though. In the third minute, a ball was played over the top to Jake Ferguson, and his cross was not dealt with by the opposition goalkeeper, and Seton found themselves 1-0 up for very bizarre circumstances. Wilson did nearly hit back straight away. A ball was played through to their striker Chris Fairless, and with only a goalkeeper to beat, he pulled his shot just wide of the target. There were a few chances for both teams after this, but unfortunately the windy conditions on the day dictated the game and made any actual football difficult to do. Seton nearly scored a second thanks to the windy conditions. James Paylor's free kick sailing over everyone, and then the opposition goalkeeper made an absolute mess of catching the ball. Soon after, Wolverhampton then got on the attack. Another ball forward found their striker in plenty of space, but a mixture of a missed kick and the wind made his lob easy pickings for Seton's goalkeeper. Just before half time, however, Wolverhampton equalised. A good ball forward again catching out the Seton defence, and Fairless slotted under the goalkeeper to make it 1-1. Seton nearly hit back with an instant reply. A ball over the top was chased down by Luke Hogan, who got to the ball before the goalkeeper did. Unfortunately, his shot across goal just clipping the post and going out of play. The half-time whistle went, and while they didn't find themselves in front, Seton enjoyed a good half and looked to build on that and maybe go on to win the game in the second half. Second half was again mostly dictated by the wind. Both sides did have the chances, but both were unable to find the net and rued their missed chances. Then came the deciding moment in the game. Seaton forward Stephen Chapman was put for own goal. Originally he was pulled back, but the ref played on. As he took a shot, he was impeded by the Wolverhampton defender. Everyone could see it was a penalty, but the referee waved away the protest, and this seemed to hit Seaton very hard, and Wolverhampton then began to pile on the pressure, but again not putting away their glorious chances. Unfortunately though, Wolverhampton weren't going to keep on missing, and Seaton's efforts to hold on for a draw were undone in the 88th minute. A short corner wasn't dealt with quick enough, and the ball eventually found its way to Lee Butterworth, who smashed in the winner from the edge of the box. Mark Lyons, the manager, was understandably disappointed, but given the depleted squad, Seaton could be very happy with their efforts from the game and could maybe go on to win their next home fixture. In their next game, Seaton faced high-flying Whitehaven AFC. Could Seaton cause an upset, or would it be more disappointing for the Seasiders?